It's tick season, guys. In this video, we will show you the 5 most dangerous ticks that you need to worry about. So we're gonna cover the diseases these ticks carry and what to do if you're bitten. Make sure to stick around for number 1, because this tick is so dangerous, it's life-threatening. Coming in at number 5, we have the Lone Star tick, named for the distinctive white dot that you can find on adult females. You'll mostly find these ticks in the eastern United States, and they are very aggressive biters. In fact, they are so aggressive that they're much more likely to bite humans when compared to other species of ticks. But what makes this tick really stand out is that it can make you allergic to red meat. Here's how it works. The Lone Star tick transmits a sugar molecule called alpha-gal into your bloodstream. In some people, this triggers a delayed allergic reaction to mammal meat, which would be beef, pork, and lamb. And the reaction it causes can be severe. We're talking rashes, vomiting, and even anaphylactic shock. And it doesn't stop there. These ticks also carry 2 serious types of bacterial infections that can cause fever, muscle aches, and even organ failure if untreated. So the Lone Star tick isn't just a nuisance, it's a potential lifestyle changer. And what's really scary is that their range is currently expanding. So your chances of running into these Lone Star ticks is only going up. If you suspect you've been bitten by a Lone Star tick, you definitely want to seek medical attention. But this is only number 5 on our list. The next one is a real wild card. Coming in at number 4, we have the Asian longhorn tick, which is a newcomer to the United States and has presented a serious mystery. First spotted in New Jersey in 2017, this invasive species is now spread over a dozen states in America. And what's really shocking is how this tick reproduces. The Asian longhorn tick is able to reproduce without mating. Heard me right. That means a single female can unleash an entire infestation. This process is known as parthenogenesis, a natural form of asexual reproduction where an embryo develops from an unfertilized egg. What this means is their population can explode fast. They've been known to drain the blood of livestock dry in Asia. And I mean that literally, thousands of ticks swarming a single animal. Now, what about humans? Well, in Asia, this tick has been linked to rickettsiosis, and in some cases, a severe fever with a syndrome that can lead to a deadly hemorrhagic disease. Luckily, in the US, we haven't had any major outbreaks yet, but scientists are watching very closely because we don't know what this tick is capable of. So when it comes to the Asian longhorn tick, it's not what we know that scares us as much as what we don't. But the next tick on the list causes a disease that is feared all over the world. At number 3, we have the black-legged tick, more famously known as the deer tick. This tiny tick is no bigger than a poppy seed and is responsible for the most common and feared tick-borne illness in America, which of course is Lyme disease. But here's the twist you might not know. These ticks don't start out infected. The real villain here is a tiny bacteria where a young tick called a larva is usually infected when they feed on small animals like mice and other rodents. Once infected by this bacteria, the tick carries it for life, and as it matures and looks for bigger meals like birds, deer, and I'm sorry to say, humans, that's when things get risky. If an infected tick bites you, it can transfer this bacteria right into your bloodstream. But it doesn't happen instantly. It usually takes 24 to 48 hours for this disease-causing bacteria to be transmitted. Once inside you, though, this bacteria can spread through your skin, your bloodstream, and your nervous system, causing early symptoms, which of course includes the telltale sign, that bullseye rash, but can also include fever, fatigue, and joint pain. And this is where it gets really bad. If left untreated, it becomes Lyme disease, which can lead to serious long-term issues like arthritis, heart problems, and other serious neurological symptoms. So if you find one of these ticks and you think it's been attached for more than a day, it's very important that you seek medical attention. Lyme disease is easily treatable with antibiotics only if caught early. And yes, I've actually had this happen to me. I was once bitten by a deer tick that crawled up my leg and actually bit me in the knee. And I remember when I got home from my hike, I had pain in my kneecap. And when I went to go look, of course, I had the tiniest little tick lodged in my skin. When I removed it, I quickly realized that I was bitten by a deer tick, and the next day, I had the bullseye rash. So I went to the doctor, and they gave me a 2-day prescription of doxycycline, which completely eliminated the rash and my chance of contracting that long-term Lyme disease. And while we're on the subject of health, have you ever thought about the health of your scalp? After a few weeks of using Kitsch shampoo and conditioner bars, I could say they're a total game changer. Formulated with rice water, these shampoo and conditioner bars help me maintain healthier hair. And honestly, my hair feels softer,
thicker, and healthier than ever. Plus, rice protein is set to boost hair volume by 20% in just 5 washes. It gives your hair a nourishing cleanse that helps encourage length and density. And all that with no parabens, no sulfates, no silicone, just clean ingredients that work. And since they're solid bars, they save 2 plastic bottles per set. So good for your hair and good for the planet. Additionally, they take up a lot less travel space than bottles in my travel kit. And get this, the combo of shampoo and conditioner, less than $25 when you use my code, which auto applies for 25% off site-wide if you use the link in the description. And there's even a subscription option for better value. Kitsch also ships to the United States and over 90 countries worldwide. That's Kitsch. And if you try this out, you'll never go back to bottles.
So yes, it's very important that if you're ever exploring the wilderness and you're bitten by a super small tick, that you pay attention to the warning signs. And if you need to, get on that antibiotic right away. So I bet a lot of you who started this video thought that the deer tick was probably going to be number one, and it's not. The next two ticks are even worse. Coming in at number 2 is the American dog tick, which is especially common in open fields and meadows in the United States. And like many other tick species, you'll often find them on tips of blades of grass and branches, ready to latch onto anything or anyone passing them by. And despite their name, these ticks bite humans just as readily as they do our pets. And what is really scary is this is the species of tick that can give you Rocky Mountain spotted fever. And while not all dog ticks carry this disease, the ones that do can really put you down. When an infected dog tick latches to your skin, it doesn't transmit the bacteria that causes Rocky Mountain spotted fever instantly. It typically takes at least 6 to 10 hours, and sometimes longer, for that bacteria to travel from the tick's saliva and into your bloodstream. But here's where it gets really scary. Unlike Lyme disease, Rocky Mountain spotted fever can progress quickly, leading to organ failure, tissue damage, and yes, even death, especially if it's not treated right away. That's why doctors often start antibiotics right after a Rocky Mountain spotted fever is suspected, even before the test results come back. And here's the catch, the telltale rash doesn't always show up. And that delay in diagnosis is what can make Rocky Mountain spotted fever so very life-threatening. And the statistics around Rocky Mountain spotted fever are startling. If left untreated, the mortality rate of this disease is near 30%. And to put that in perspective, the average of all the Ebola strains has a mortality rate of 50%. So yes, Rocky Mountain spotted fever is over half as deadly as Ebola. Seeing as this tick is common, it definitely pays to protect yourself and protect your pets, because the dog tick isn't just a nuisance, it's a potential killer. Now, to put your fears at ease, the kicker here is not all dog ticks carry Rocky Mountain spotted fever, and with treatment, Rocky Mountain spotted fever has a very low mortality rate. And that's why we always recommend, if you're ever bitten by any animal, to always seek medical attention. And if Rocky Mountain spotted fever doesn't scare you enough, how about paralysis? Finally, at number 1, the worst tick and the one that we deem the most dangerous that you need to look out for is the Australian paralysis tick. Of course it's from Australia. Found along the eastern coast of Australia, this tick doesn't just bite, it shuts your body down. When this tick bites, it doesn't just feed on your blood, it also injects you with a powerful neurotoxin. Scientists believe this toxin evolved to stop the host from scratching or removing the tick so it can stay attached longer to feed on your blood. These ticks will suck and suck and suck until they are massive. And we've seen some giant Australian ticks firsthand. They are nasty. The Australian paralysis tick is a major threat to pets like dogs and cats, but humans can also be affected, with children being particularly vulnerable. The toxin interferes with the nerve signal, particularly in the junctions where nerves connect to your muscles. And this can lead to paralysis, starting with weakness in the legs and potentially spreading upward to your arms, face, and even the muscles that control breathing. That's bad. Victims can experience slurred speech, difficulty breathing, and in severe cases, full respiratory collapse. Unfortunately, there's no vaccine, and the only treatment is immediate tick removal to stop that neurotoxin from injecting you any further. And even then, recovery can take days or weeks, even when seeking medical treatment in intensive care. And just goes to show you that in nature, even the smallest creatures can possess terrifying power. Whether it's meat allergies, life-threatening illnesses, or even paralysis, you don't want these parasites anywhere near your skin. So stay aware, stay protected, and if you ever suspect that you're bitten by one of these ticks, make sure you look for those early warning signs and always seek medical attention. I hope everyone has a safe and happy summer, and keep those pant legs rolled down, because the ticks, they are biting.